Mr. Excel Podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 1481. Repeat a macro for each cell in column A. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jell, and today's question is sent in by JK. JK has a little macro that he wrote, and right now it runs on the current cell. Now, he didn't tell me what his macro is. I just wrote a little macro here. I press Control A, and see, because this has 7, it put the letter E over in the 7th column. I don't know, just some stupid little, I don't know what JK's macro does. But the point is, how do we take whatever macro we have and make it work for every single value that we have in column A? Now, in my case, I know that I want to start in row 2 and go down to the last row. So I'm going to switch over to VBA, and I'm going to use my very favorite line of code, the line of code I use over and over and over. Final row is equal to cells, rows.count, comma 1, dot end, XL up dot row. All right. And what does that do? That says, hey, go down to the last row in the spreadsheet today. That's either 1,048,576 or 65,536 or 16,384. If you're back in Excel 95, who would be there? And it presses the end key and then the up arrow key and figures out what row we're at. So that's going to tell us in this case that we have 15 rows of data today. And then I'm going to say for I equals 2, starting row 2 to final row, then all of the macro that I have, I'm just going to indent that, and then next I. Okay, now we could make it go through and just select that cell. So cells I comma 1 dot select. But you know, that's the way the macro recorder does things. We really don't have to do that. We already know that this row is equal to I, so we can get rid of that variable altogether. And then when we refer to this row, we can just say I, and again here, I, and then the magic, there you go. All right, so now this macro will now work on every single value in column A. So let's just control A, bam, and they're all done like that. Even if I had 1,000 or 10,000 or 1,000,000, very quickly, it would be done rather than me pressing Control A, down arrow, Control A, down arrow, Control A, down arrow, Control A, down arrow. Now JK said, hey, I bet you're gonna have to use count or count A to do that. And I could see where you could potentially do that, but this is just, you know, a handy way. We have variables, what the heck, let's use them. Figure out where the last row is, and then set up a little loop for I equals 2 to that last row, and next I, good to go. All right, well, hey, I want to thank JK for sending that question in. I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.